Welcome back to Proactive. Today I'm joined by Lithium Energy's Chairman William Johnson. William, great to have you in our studio today. Trust you've been keeping well.
Thanks, Alicia. Yes, I have.
Will, it's great to talk a little bit more about what's happening over at your graphite project today. But before we get into all of that news, I'm just wondering if you can give us a quick overview of Lithium Energy's vision. What are you out to achieve?
Yes, thanks, Alicia. And certainly the recent drilling results we've had from our graphite project in Queensland have been spectacular, but I'll get to those in a moment. So look, Lithium Energy Ltd, we were one of the best performing IPOs of 2021 when we listed the company. And what's really unique about Lithium Energy is that we are the only company listed on ASX which has significant exposure to the two most important ingredients for lithium ion batteries, being lithium and graphite. Our flagship project is our Solar's lithium brine project in Argentina, where we've made a significant major lithium discovery already. We're in the middle of a major drilling program there, and our objective there is to define a very large, high quality resource of lithium brine, ultimately for use in lithium ion batteries. But the second project is our Burke Graphite project in Queensland, which is really interesting because it's turning out to be one of the highest grade graphite deposits in the world. And graphite's been sort of one of those commodities that has sort of been a bit forgotten about over the last couple of years, but more recently, I think people are recognizing how important graphite is, particularly for use in electric vehicle batteries. I mean, typically in a lithium ion battery, about up to 30% of a battery's ingredients, that's graphite. So graphite makes up a huge part of the sort of lithium ion battery requirements moving forward. And so we are very excited to have two fantastic projects in this battery mineral space.
Certainly sounds like you've got the double whammy there, obviously two minerals that are highly critical to the battery supply chain. But William, let's talk a little bit more about what's happening at your Burke Graphite project, where you've just announced results for seven more reverse circulation drill holes. Tell us a little bit about what you found and why it's important.
Yes, Alicia. Well, I mean, we've just over the last few weeks, we've been releasing progressively the results of our drilling, and the results have been incredible. I mean, most large graphite deposits around the world have grades of graphite typically between sort of 5 or 10% on average. Our grades have been consistently over 20%, and we're having intersections of more than 25-26% graphite. To give you an indication of what that looks like, this is a big chunk of 25% graphite. You just don't see this anywhere else in Australia and very few places in the world. So we're sort of really excited to have our hands on this deposit. And I guess these results just really emphasize the high quality of this deposit and the incredibly high grades. And what that means moving forward is, as we advance to develop this project, the high grades mean that we have the opportunity to mine this at relatively low cost compared to lower quality deposits. And also the quality of the graphite that we have is really important when you consider its use going into lithium-ion batteries. I mean, the quality of the graphite in a lithium-ion battery is essential for controlling the battery storage capacity, discharge rates, and cycle times, all of which are really important criteria for the battery minerals manufacturers.
Mm. Really good to get a sense visually of exactly what's coming out of the ground, and also to hear about that in the context of a potential production scenario as well. William, the big question is, there's a long way to go from here to there, but what are your next steps? How do you get there?
Sure. So the current drilling program that we're doing, the main purpose of that is to upgrade the confidence in our resource and then to use that to advance with engineering studies, which we're about to kick off. And the purpose of these studies is really to confirm the economic and commercial feasibility to move into the mining and production stage. We're not just looking to mine the graphite and sell it as a raw material. Our plan is to transform the graphite, ideally here in Australia, into a high value anode material, and we believe that our deposit is really well placed to do that because of, firstly, the very high grade of the material as a starting point, and secondly, being located here in Australia, obviously there's a lot less sovereign risk compared to a lot of the other graphite projects around the world, particularly in those some of those African countries. And our location, which is relatively close to Townsville, which is rapidly becoming a bit of a battery minerals hub in Queensland, gives us distinct logistics advantages too. And finally, there's potentially a lot of government and regional support that is now being offered by the government to encourage companies like ours to advance with these kind of projects, particularly for the processing and manufacturing stage.
Good to hear about what could be a domestic processing option down the track. Just before we end off today, William, any news that investors should be looking out for from your Argentina lithium project?
Yes, definitely, Alicia. As I said, we're sort of working our way through a fairly extensive drilling program. We're progressively releasing the announce of this program, and our aim is to have a maiden JORC resource of lithium released to the market in the first half of this year.
William, I'm sure we'll get you back in the studio for another update on that when the information comes to hand. But thanks so much for your time and your insights on the graphite results today.
Thanks, Alicia. My pleasure.